No one wants zero. No one wants nothing. Yeah? Where are you going this weekend? I'm going to the horse racing track down in Goodwood. Yeah? Great. What an experience. What are you hoping to do there? Well, I'm just going to go down and see the... Well, I'm... Well... Nothing. You're going to Goodwood to do nothing? Yeah, but you'll be placing a bet on it. No. How are you going to win? What's the point, you see? You're going to see the horses? No. Ah, oh, you see, you're going to meet your family. Is it a reunion? You know, it's something that you do every year. No. It's a nice part of the country, you know. So you're going to see the landscapes, you know, and this beautiful green grass in Goodwood. It's a beautiful stadium, isn't it? No. So why are you going? I don't know. I'm going to remain optimistic, you see. I'm just going to go. I have got no intent, no ulterior motive, no hopes. No gains. No reasons. In fact, I don't know why I'm going. In fact, I don't know who I'm going with. In fact, I don't know where Goodwood is. You're not going to have this conversation with anyone. Even you watching now are saying, it's ridiculous, you know. He's going to Goodwood. He doesn't know why. He doesn't know where it is. And he doesn't know what he's going for. There's absolutely no point. That's what you're looking for. The point that takes you to no point. Zero. Zero is the final experience. The experience that nothing appears. No bliss. No happiness. No joy, no kundalini, no world. No you. No past, no future. No non-duality. Nothing. No mind. No less, no more, no goals, no pies at halftime, simply emptiness, simply emptiness. The original state of every human being. And you say, well, how do you know? You say, How do you know? You cannot stay zero and know. It is another experience, you see. You have to return to know. So what you're hoping for in your pretend conditioned life is that you're hoping when this body goes that you're going to experience this that I speak about, this wonderful emptiness. Yeah? But you're not going to experience it, you see? You are going to experience it when your body goes. But there's no body to come back and relive it and appreciate it and feel so joyful about it. Not the joy that you have to tell everyone that you're special and that you want to write books and that you want to record this Christ experience, our Buddha experience. Simply because it is the most revelational experience, and that you get the opportunity, even though you did not attend, the attending attended. And who is this attending, if not a body, if not a mind, if not a world? The unfortunate thing about an enlightened being is they only go from one upwards. Everything beyond one makes no sense. Is nonsense. Nonsense. But the one who goes to zero, you have to meet this one, you see. Not the one who goes to zero, because there's no one who goes to zero, but you have to meet this going to zero. But who meets going to zero? It is the after effect, the after return. It's like you get absolutely drunk for the first time in your life as a teenager, and you cannot remember the next day what happened. When you wake up the next day, you cannot remember anything, but something happened that made you feel so wonderful. Your mind did not attend this drunkenness. You were absolutely on your face. But the next day, something says, I feel good about it, you know. I feel good about something that happened. And I think there's an essence, a remembrance, a recollection of it involved a girl or a boy, whichever sex you are watching. But you cannot explain it, you see. But unless you woke up the next morning, there's no opportunity for you to even relive this, wow, what happened? I hope you understand this, you see. You're waking up from an absolute drunken stupor. You cannot remember anything, but something inside said it was beautiful or horrible. Something inside knows, you see. And that is what going to zero is like. There's no you in zero. But when you wake it up, wow. Wow. Zero is the final experience. No guru. Although many who have refused to speak about it, my masters, have experienced it. But to communicate with you, non-duality is acceptable. See, you can accept non-duality. But you cannot accept zero until you have been zerofied, nullified, pardon me. So what this video is to say, it is available, but you have to be in a drunken stupor, but no alcohol is involved. Rumi speaks about it. Rumi speaks about this drunken stupor. Not many will have this desire to get so drunk. So drunk with themselves. To be so disillusioned with this world. So disillusioned with this world that you have to, there's no option, go inside and say, you know what? I can only rely on one thing. I cannot rely on anything except myself. And there's no ego here, you see. There's no gains. There's no wanting to invest in something. It's just that, you know, trust is here. Simple trust. Rumi. The biggest gift you can have in the world is to see this, what Rumi saw, and realize that you are absolutely drunk with love, with ignorance when you saw it. And the secondary gift, you're still in a body and you can relive it even though you can't speak about it. Namaste.